Well, folks, the Hoos were back in Charlottesville today to take on the Maryland Terrapins in hopes of breaking their four-game losing streak. However, unfortunately, the Hoos suffered another discouraging loss, increasing their losing streak to 5 games. This leaves players and coaches scrambling to salvage the season.
Great effort by the guys, but again, great effort doesn't end in the result of a W. You know, still a loss. We need to get better at that.
Maryland's Stephon Diggs returned the opening kickoff to put the Hoos down 7-0 before they even had a chance to really take the field. And then they found themselves down 14-0 only about 5 minutes into the first quarter. From then on out, the Hoos struggled to regain any sort of offensive momentum, and the end score ended up being 27-20.
It's disappointing for things to occur, as we saw the long touchdown on the kickoff return. Stephon Diggs, excellent player, excellent receiver for them. That's 4 catches for 89 yards, and 160-yarder was on one play of that. It's for 60 yards. We talk about reducing our turnovers, and of course we get a costly one there, and we finally get a turnover. And that's the kind of thing that that we need to happen to us, and just not enough good things happen to us today, particularly in the end, to pull this thing out.
Quarterback Phillip Sims recorded his second start for the Cavaliers today, but in an ironic turn of events was pulled late in the fourth quarter to allow Michael Rocco to make a scoring touchdown drive, throwing a pass to Jake McGee in the end zone. Both of these players say the competition is fairly healthy and they have a good relationship with each other off the field and are just working to do what they can to make the team successful.
Make some throws for Phillip to have success with some completions and just didn't get it done with the completions.
Down to me, I'm the quarterback. I gotta put the ball in everybody's hands, and I didn't do it.
Yeah, we try to just get a lot of completions this week. Just try to get going early and often, and I just didn't do my job.
I think Mike did a good job of coming in and making some throws there, leading us to a scoring drive. He's a competitor, and he wouldn't doubt he'd do anything else to try to give us his absolute best effort and a chance to try to win the game here towards the end.
I believe in myself. I believe in my teammates. So I really just did my job, and it worked out on the one drive, but we came up short. I mean, my goal as a competitor is to win the game, and my goal as a quarterback is to win the games, and we came up short, so it's always disappointing.
I do what I'm told. They tell me Rock's going in the game. I sit down and I get on the sideline and I cheer for him the same way he cheered for me. So that's the way you got to be as a team player.
When asked about the general team mentality after a 5-game losing streak, the players stated that obviously the team was down and were working to stay positive so that they could take on their new opponent, Wake Forest, for next week and try to turn things around and find success this season.
It hurts. To me, it hurts. To me, like I said, you go in each and every week and you feel good, you work hard each and every week, and that's what we still going to continue to do. Go in that weight room, work hard, get in that film room, be our best film critiques on ourselves, and get ready for Wake Forest this week.
And as you could expect in any team with a streak like this, it's a pretty down group right now. And you pretty much couldn't expect anything else from this team. I mean, you wouldn't expect for guys to lose 3 or 4 games in a row and be jumping around and all happy, go lucky and stuff like that. So it's a pretty down group right about now, and it's gonna take some time, and it's gonna take some corrections to get this turned around.
When you get in a hole like that, you just gotta stay mentally tough and keep working through it and dig your way out.
It's disappointing because I feel like we've worked to get us to a point where we should be winning. And I think we've worked really hard, this offseason. We worked extremely hard. And I think we were challenged this offseason with adversity, and I just think it's not being shown on Saturday. So it's pretty disappointing coming out here, every week, knowing that you work extremely hard, preparing, hours within a day, sacrificing so much of your life, just to come out here on Saturday. So, but with me, I've always been a very optimistic person. I'd always kept my faith strong, so like I tell the guys and like I try to teach the other guys, just keep going, because at the end of the day, you always want to end on a good note. You always want to end fighting. You never want to show your opponent or the rest of the season that you quit early. So when it comes down to it, you got to continue to fight.
We're going through some adversity here on the football field, and that's what happens, and the worst thing we can do now is start talking about pointing fingers and blaming and things like that. I will continue to work as hard as I can to make sure that this team, the players, have an opportunity to be a successful player once they finish playing, to get them coached up the way they need to get coached up, and that's making sure the coaches are accountable for that, more resolved and resolute to help these young men experience success on the field as they are in other areas.
Next week, the Hoos are at home taking on Wake Forest, again in hopes of breaking the losing streak and finding the win column one more time. We'll see you all there. And for Sabre TV, I'm Miranda Mason.